I'm going to show you how to create this custom pin code. So if you look at it here, because I have it here. Okay, so if you look at this, you can figure out that we have the option to create the pin code. I can delete it here. So you can see I can add it. And I click on that and that should be sorted out. Okay, so what you're going to do is you need to figure out how to do it. So the first thing you need to do is you notice that I have a pin code, which is obviously the widgets component from Waterflow. So you have that pin code, and if you click on it, obviously you can have some adjustments you can make. So there you go. So I'm not really going to show you step by step how to do it, but I'm going to give you a flow or a step of how you're going to do it. So these are buttons, all of them are buttons, you can design them the way you like. And on each button, have an action, right? So I have a haptic feedback and I have a custom action, which I'll show you what that does, and have a set form field. So the set form field, I'm just updating this pin code, this particular pin code, with the data that I get from my page state. Right. So if you click on this, you notice I have a page state here, which is a string. So it has to be a string. So you can convert it back to an integer if you need it to be an integer, but it has to be a string for it to work. Otherwise, you can still make it work with an integer, but when you delete everything, you're going to have the last value as a zero. So you have to make it a string. Now the custom action I have here, what it does is that it accepts this number, which you have here, and then it's going to update the page state which we have. So let me show you the page states I have. So I have two page states. I have pin code, which is a string. You can go ahead and update your page state, call it whatever you want. I have pin code here. And now, inside my custom state, which is the pin code, I can go ahead and update it. So for example, if I go to custom actions, so where I have this custom action, what it does is that you notice that it accepts a string, a number, which is a string, and then it adds it to the update pin code, right? So these are where we're going to add it. So what it does is that instead of replacing the whole pin code, it just adds to what was already there in the string. So if you have one, the next value is going to be now the next value add. So it's going to be a list of numbers. Alright, so you're also making sure that they are not more than four. So for my situation, I want it to be just four, so you can have to set your own condition. So this is a function you just need to create, and then you need to pass it there. So as you can see, I'm passing that function here, and I'm adding the number one. And after that is done, I'm now going to now update our form field, which is a pin code, with a pin code app state, which we have created. Good. So you're going to do the same thing also for number two. Same thing, only that you're going to now give that number two. Number three, everything will be the same. Now, the last part is the option to delete these items. So if I go to here, you notice I'm doing four things. Obviously, the first thing is the haptic. Now, the second thing we are doing is removing the last pin code digit. After you have removed the last pin code digit, you need to update now the app state with the new app state. So as you can see, this is a little bit strange if you if you're seeing it for the first time. So the first thing we are going to do here is that we keep in mind that, let me just show you how this happens. When you go to the custom action for removing the last pin code, this is what you need to create in there. And one more thing you'll notice is that this update, we are removing the last item on the pin state. Remember in the last code I showed you for adding, we are adding it to the last position. So what you're going to be doing here for it to be deletable. So for example, if I come here, if I delete this, you notice I only deleted 5. Right? And then I deleted that as a 5. So if I add another 6, I can delete the 6 and that. So that's what happened. So when we click on this, we are adding to the already existing list. When I click on this, I'm removing the last item on the existing list so that I can add the new one. So now the point of doing that is so that we can delete them systematically. And now as you can see, we are deleting these update value. Now the problem with this approach is that if you leave it just like this, it's only going, yes, it's going to remove it, but you're not going to see the real-time updates here. So if I delete this, you see it's happening immediately. So if I just use that function for that particular reason, I will not, it will still be removed, but it will not update on this widget. So the way we counter that is when we remove the item, we are going to now update the page state, the same page state, we're going to update it with itself. So what I mean with itself is that it's going to be updated based on now the new current value. So this is going to be useful for when you're doing it in the front. Now, once that has been done, what we're going to do now is now update the pin code with now the new state. So that's going to ensure that this pin code also is going to be displaying in real time, right? So when that changes, it's going to be displaying in real time. So that's what how you do it. And so you don't have to keep doing custom widgets for the pin code. You can just do it this way. So in case you have any issues, maybe you are doing getting from PubDev, you can just do it this way without having to keep getting everything from PubDev. So this is an easy way of you handling this. Right, so in case of any questions, just leave them in the comment section. If you need a code, let me know. I can also paste it somewhere. And yeah, all right, that'll be it.